China without a question. They're wiping us around the world economically. Yeah.
We have to hold China accountable. They steal our products, including our intellectual property. They dump substandard products into our economy.
The Chinese government has not been open their press. The freedom of press does not exist there. Their human rights record is abominable.
China would like to see sneaky Joe Biden. They would take this country for a ride like you've never seen before.
I would be on the phone with China and making it clear, we are going to need to be in your country. You have to be open. They must play by the rules. Period, period, period.
Perhaps it's a surprise to no one that China looks set to be a major topic in the 2020 US presidential election. From the 2016 campaign to the Trump administration, the current president of the United States has put China at the center of his policy and political ideology. The political establishment has followed in his footsteps, and COVID-19 pushed this obsession into overdrive. On April 24th, Politico reported that the National Republican Senatorial Committee distributed a memo instructing Republican candidates to address the coronavirus crisis by aggressively attacking China. Three lines are suggested. China is covering up COVID-19, Democrats are soft on China, and Republicans will impose sanctions on China for its inability to control the pandemic. And inevitably, the Republican critique invited a counterattack from the Democratic Party. Each side is now trying to one-up the other in the who's tougher on China debate.
President Trump may think his being tough on China, all that he has delivered as a consequence of that, is American farmers, manufacturers, and consumers losing and paying more.
Everyone should be aware of Joe Biden's history of being too cozy with China and going soft on China, and it really begins with saying that they are not an economic threat.
This is China's role in the 2020 election, to give partisan leaders a chance to voice strength over adversaries. Talk of the China threat and holding China accountable for COVID-19 masks the fact that these politicians and operatives are trying to convey a sense of dominance.
Remember last year when China and the United States are locked in this the trade war, President Trump also said that China wants him gone, wanted to have a softer democratic presidency, particularly actually if you look at Nancy Pelosi, Chuck Schumer, and also Joe Biden himself, they've been criticizing China for a long time, the House Democrats. And also Joe Biden himself recently also toughened his tone on China. So overall, I think this is not a pure Republican strategy. Democrats also wanted to criticize China. It is just that they want to criticize Trump more. At this point, Democrats wanted to make the election of 2020 a national referendum on Trump himself.
And in all honesty, public opinion gives them a reason to do so. Pew Research Center's recent poll suggests 66% of Americans view China unfavorably, and 62% believe that China is a major threat to the US. Across the political spectrum, more and more Americans have a negative opinion about China. Where public opinion goes, politicians are likely to follow. Mitt Romney, senator from Utah and the Republican nominee for president in 2012, published an opinion piece in the Washington Post on April 24th. China's stranglehold on pharmaceuticals is only a small sliver of its grand strategy for economic, military, and geopolitical domination, he wrote, before describing COVID-19 as a clarion call for America to seize the moment.
If Chinese students want to come here and study Shakespeare and the Federalist Papers, that's what they need to learn from America. They don't need to learn quantum computing and artificial intelligence from America.
Indoctrination contradicts America's idea of freedom. But telling people what should be learned projects a sense of authority over the target. The notion of breaking China's stranglehold plays into the parallel in US history of gaining independence by overthrowing the imperial authority. During election campaigns, strength and patriotism are often the greatest rallying rhetoric. Unfortunately, China drew the short straw and looks likely to be a bogeyman in the campaigning ahead.